when you plan a whole season, it's all about balance. We've had big symphonies. We've had Bruckner, and we've had Mahler, and we've had Mozart. We've had kind of big symphonic statements. Well, we have something very different to close the season, and that is ballet music. Igor Stravinsky wrote in 1910 The Firebird. 1911 he wrote Petrushka. 1913 he wrote The Rite of Spring. These three huge works. And so our audiences will be hearing these, you know, kind of on the 100th anniversary of their birth. And so The Firebird is the first one. Later, Stravinsky created a suite because this music is so colorful. And so, you know, it comes right out of the great Tchaikovsky tradition of the full evening ballet, Tchaikovsky and Rimsky-Korsakov. And, you know, it comes absolutely right out of that tradition. And especially The Firebird, the one we're going to play this year in 2010, is so, it uses Russian folk music, and it uses the great colors of the orchestra, like Rimsky-Korsakov, like Tchaikovsky. And so it's the most kind of Russian of Stravinsky pieces. In 1919, he made a suite from the full evening ballet. So he made about a 20-minute suite containing kind of the hits. And so it's become a concert staple, a great virtuosic showpiece for orchestra, and a, you know, blazing ending, which of course is very important to end the season with that piece. So I kind of predicated this whole concert around playing the Firebird Suite. And so what commented on that? Well, another American ballet. We have a Russian ballet, and so I thought a piece that's very close to me is Appalachian Spring, Aaron Copland's wonderful ballet, written right at the end of World War II, kind of the quintessential American piece. Originally written for a very small ensemble, because during the war, you know, we didn't have big orchestras or big ballet companies. But Martha Graham's company used a 13-piece ensemble. And this music was so popular and so evocative, and again, folk-based, just like the Stravinsky Firebird Suite, you know, very much folk song-based. And so Stravinsky kind of put it in a larger orchestral context, put different clothing on it, and expanded it a little bit. And so we have the Appalachian Spring Suite. And, you know, it's, again, music that everybody knows and loves and has been used on commercials and everything else. And, again, a piece that is very, I mean, you can tell when it was composed. We have the kind of joy of being American and the whole kind of openness of America. And we also have great thoughtfulness and prayer and, you know, the whole idea. It portrays a young couple getting married and their thoughts and their joys and their doubts and, you know, and everything in between. And so a quintessential American piece, Appalachian Spring, a show-stopping Russian piece at the end. And in between those two great ballets is Tchaikovsky's first piano concerto, you know, one of the warhorse concertos, you know, the piece that Van Cliburn played at the Tchaikovsky competition in Moscow way back when and triumphed and kind of took over the world. Norman Krieger, a wonderful pianist with whom I've worked in every orchestra that I've conducted. And so I've invited him to come and share his talents with the Quad Cities audiences and orchestra. And he is a powerful pianist, and this is a big, big, powerful piece and, you know, kind of a show-stopping virtuoso piece. So we have two Russians, Tchaikovsky and Stravinsky, and then open with American music. And I think a program of great variety and a program that's extremely different from each of the programs in the whole season. And so I think a wonderful way to close my second season here.